Hello students, and welcome to part 2 of the lesson Onto the Summit, We Reach the Top. So let us continue where we left yesterday. What does it matter whether I reach the top first or Hillary? Our main thought was that both of us reached the top. We had to. One couldn't do it alone. So here we see that when Tenzing Norgay was questioned by everyone as to among both of them, who was the first one to reach the summit of Mount Everest? And he answers them saying that it was not important whether he, or that is Edmund Hillary, was the first or I reached first. It was the achievement of both of them because it was not a task that someone would do alone, on their own. In order to reach the top, they needed the support of another person, and that was one of them. So it was not important who was first, but the fact that they both reached the summit was important. Okay, so there had been a difference of 1,000 feet between us, and they could claim that, you know, he was first or I was first, but even then they just, you know, stick to this thing that only the man behind him could confirm the distance between the two of them. The one who was ahead could not look behind and decide as to how much was the distance, because it was a very, very dangerous place for them to think about all of these petty things. So when they reached Kathmandu, they discovered that a controversy, okay, that is prolonged public disagreement or heated discussion, had begun, and everybody was talking about it. Hillary, that is Edmund Hillary, Colonel Hunt, the one who was their leader, and Tenzing Norgay, they three of them had a discussion, and they agreed that all the talk was childish. What was the controversy? That some of them were saying that no, Tenzing Norgay was the first to reach. Some were saying that Edmund Hillary was first to reach. But they three agreed that it is not a single person's achievement, but they are both achievement as a whole. So they made a pact, that is a formal agreement between individuals or parties. Okay, today they are saying like that, but tomorrow they should not change their words. So they made a formal agreement, okay, a formal paper, and each of us signed this agreement in the office of Prime Minister of Nepal, okay. Now, what was this agreement about? In this agreement, each one signed his own statement, okay. So Edmund Hillary has written whatever he felt, and he has signed it, and Tenzing Norgay has written his thoughts, and he has signed it. And Edmund Hillary's copy is with Tenzing Norgay, and Tenzing Norgay's copy is with Edmund Hillary. That today they are saying that it is both of their achievement. Tomorrow they should not change their statement that no, I was the first to reach the summit. And so it was better to have a formal document in order to maintain stability. Okay, so this statement that Edmund Hillary had written was in Tenzing Norgay's pocket, and he read that statement to them, and it reads Kathmandu, June 22nd, 1953. That is when they came back from the expedition. On May 29th, Tenzing Sherpa and I left our high camp on Mount Everest for our attempt on the summit. As we climbed upwards to the south summit, first one and then the other would take a turn at leading. We crossed over the south summit and moved along the summit ridge. That is a long, narrow piece of raised land. We reached the summit almost together. So the same thing was written in Tenzing Sherpa's note as well. Okay. So it states that none of them was the first or second, but they reached the summit together. So here we can see, you know, how they kept moving from one place to another, and then they went towards the north, reaching the topmost point. And after they reached the summit, you can imagine the happiness that they both must have, experienced, because they had set a world record. they had done something that no one else had done on this planet, that is reaching the topmost point of the Earth's surface. So their happiness knew no bounds, and they just embraced each other. Embraced as in to hug someone, to hold them tightly, okay, into one's arm. So they hugged each other, so overjoyed at their success. And then, in order that they had proofs that they reached the summit, they Edmund Hillary started taking photos of the place, of the scenery that he could see from the summit of Mount Everest. And he also took photograph of Tenzing holding the flags of Great Britain, Nepal, United Nations, and India. Okay, so this is what Edmund Hillary had written in his note, and he signed this note, okay, in order to keep this document full proof that yes, it is true and it cannot be changed or amended by anyone. So there is another paper like this in English which was signed by Tenzing Norgay. Okay, so thus we will not take part in any controversy. So they then, you know, made up their mind that let people talk whatever they want to talk, but when it comes to them, if anybody asks them, then their statement will say that Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay embraced each other when they reached the top, and we did it together. Okay, we did it as well as our bulky equipments would let us. Okay, because they had so much of weight on their backs, of the oxygen cylinder and all the equipments that they were carrying. In spite of that, as much as they could, they just embraced each other. So Tenzing Norgay, he remembers saying to Edmund Hillary that we have done it, okay, but their mouths were covered with the oxygen mask, and so maybe they couldn't hear each other, but they definitely felt the happiness that the other person experienced at that moment. So the first thought, on reaching the top was the sense of gratitude to God. Look at this, my dear students. This is a very, very important statement that we all need to remember always in our life. Okay, always in our life. He could have said, I thank this one, I have thanked that one for making this journey. But no, he realizes that he was at that point only because of the grace of God. If it was not for God's blessings, they would have never ever made to the top. Because yes, this does involve your hard work, your skills, but at the same time, the natural elements play a very, very important role. You are at the topmost point. Now you can, you know, you all must be knowing, like, when you go on an open field and you stand there, you can just feel the air, you know, pushing you backward and forward, and you're moving so much because of the intense breeze. But you can imagine the breeze, the intensity of the breeze on the summit of Mount Everest, how harsh it would have been. But they were blessed with God's presence, and God was always, of course, with them, that they could make it to the topmost point without any accident or injury. So he had this sense of gratitude, a sense of thankfulness towards God, that after having failed six times, it was not the first time that he decided and he reached. He had tried six times and he failed. And finally, God had blessed him with fulfillment of this desire of reaching the topmost point of the Earth's surface that Tenzing Norgay had in his mind for so long. So he was thankful to God. That was the first thought that he had in his mind. And as soon as he reached on the summit, he opened a small, cloth. And in that cloth, he had carried some offerings to God. And this is in accord or in agreement with his religion, to the religion that he belonged to, that they, no matter what they do, they have to first make an offering to God. Okay. And so keeping that in mind, he had brought those, you know, small gifts for offering to God, and both his wife and he are Buddhists. So according to the Buddhist tradition, they had to make this offering. So he knelt down on the summit, and because Actually, he did not really, but he wanted to, okay. But because of his clothes and equipments, he could not kneel. But however, he stood there and he offered a silent prayer in his heart and thanked God for the entire journey. And the offerings that he had were biscuits, some candy, and a little blue pencil. How cute is that? See? You can understand the person's nature from all these actions, my dear students. How down to earth, how humble he must have been. He cared to carry that small offering that his daughter, Nima, had given him, okay, before he left home. And she, that small little girl, told him that when you reach on the top, please put this on the top of the mountain as her offering. Okay, so he had this small little pencil, blue pencil that she had given, and some biscuits and candy as his and his wife's offering to God and thank him for all that he had done in his life. Okay, so he did put this on the top of the mountain. For us, it might be an ordinary blue pencil, but not even a long one. It was not a long one, small one, but it was the most prized possession for his daughter. See, when you want to do something for someone, the moment you give your most prized possession, that shows the intensity of which you want to give something to someone. So this pencil was very dear to her. To his daughter Nima, but she wanted to give it to God and thank him for making her father successful in his feat. Okay, so she did that. So as he put it down, he pointed to Hillary that, you know, see, this is the pencil. And Hillary definitely understood that yes, this must be the pencil given to him by his daughter. So he gave him a big smile and showing that he understood that, yes, there was a lot of feeling behind this action. Then he got out the flags, which he had put on a string, which was about 4 feet long. And he fastened it or tied it up on one end to his ice axe. You know, they have this ice axe with which they take support in order to climb on the mountain. So he just tied the string to his ice axe. And then Edmund Hillary took pictures of him as he held the flags in his hand. Then now he could not keep it there because he had to use the ice axe while he came down the mountain. So what he did is he buried one end of the string on the ice on the top and the other in snow on the slope down below. Okay, in that way he managed to keep the flags over there. So when they left, they were lying flat against the summit because, of course, there was so much of wind and nothing could hold it straight, the flags, okay? So, now when they were coming down, he was really very thirsty because it had been a long journey and a tiresome journey. So, he took out a water tumbler for drinking some water, but he found that the metal container, the container that they carried water in, that was frozen. Of course it would be because it is so cold, okay? So the water had completely frozen and so he could not quench his thirst. Quench means satisfy his thirst because he did not have any water to drink. So finally he just kept it inside and he ate some biscuits and he offered some biscuits to Hillary, Edmund Hillary as well. I was wearing a red scarf. Now see, one more quality, you know, he, no matter where he was, he did not forget the little things in his life. He was wearing a red scarf, which his great friend Lambert, who was Lambert, like I told you, Tenzing Norgay had attempted climbing the mountain 6 times before as well. Okay, so during those times, he had this leader of the 1952 Swiss expedition. Okay, and his name was Lambert. And during their expedition, he had become Tenzing Norgay's good friend. So he had given him this red scarf last year. So it was just a year ago on 28th May when we were standing at 28,215 feet. He gave me the scarf. Okay, this scarf was given to him during that time. So he remembered that and he was wearing it and carried it along with him. I wore it all the way up the mountain from Darjeeling. As I stood at the top, I remembered him and felt that he was with me. Okay, why? Because he was a dear friend And like everyone in that expedition, he too wanted to reach the summit. But because it was not possible, today when he had this calf along with him, he felt that his friend was with him. So he felt absolutely fit at the summit. His mind was absolutely clear. And he did not feel tired at all. Why? Because he was very, very excited. Okay. So because of this excitement, he forgot all the tiredness that he was in. It was a very clear sensation of happiness. Okay. So my dear students, we see the various qualities of Tenzing Norgay that have been highlighted through the different incidences that we got to know today on his journey to the summit of Mount Everest. We shall get to know about some more qualities of Tenzing Norgay in our next video. Until then, please, I'm sure you have read the previous part of the lesson, but do again start from page 16, 17 and 18, and you can read up till where we discussed today. Okay, so until the next video, please take care. Go through the videos, read your textbook, and we'll see you soon. Until then, thank you and have a nice day.